Hi, welcome to the first episode of ByteByteGo System Design Video Series. In these videos, we hope to share with you system design knowledge and tips in a different format. We are new to this, so please give us feedback in the comment section below. In this first video, we'll talk about HTTP. Here in this example, Bob enters a URL into the browser and hits Enter. What happens next? Well, let's first discuss what a URL is. URL stands for Universal Resource Locator, and it has four parts. First is scheme. In this example, it's http://. This tells the browser to connect to the server using a protocol called HTTP. Another common scheme is HTTPS. With HTTPS, the connection is encrypted. The second part of the URL is a domain. In this example, example.com. It is the domain name of the site. The third part of a URL is path, and the fourth is resource. The difference between these two is often not very clear. Just think of them as directory and file in a regular file system. They together specify the resource on the server we want to load. So Bob entered the URL into the browser. What happened next? Well, the browser needs to know how to reach the server. In this case, example.com. This is done with a process called DNS lookup. DNS stands for Domain Name System. Think of it as a phone book of the internet. DNS translates domain names to IP addresses so browsers can load resources. It is an interesting service in and of itself that deserves a dedicated video that we should make later. Now, to make the lookup process fast, the DNS information is heavily cached. First, the browser itself caches it for a short period of time. And if it is not in the browser cache, the browser asks the operating system for it. The operating system itself has a cache for it, which also keeps the answer for a short period of time. Now, if the operating system doesn't have it, it makes a query out to the internet to a DNS resolver. This sets up a chain of requests until the IP address is resolved. Now, this is an elaborate and elegant process, but just to keep in mind that this process involves many servers in the DNS infrastructure, and the answer is cached every step of the way. Again, we'll discuss this in detail in another video. Now finally, the browser has the IP address of the server, in our case again, example.com. Next, the browser establishes a TCP connection with the server using the IP address it got for it. Now, there's a handshake involved in establishing a TCP connection. It takes several network round trips for this to complete. To keep the loading process fast, modern browsers use something called a keep-alive connection to try to reuse an established TCP connection to the server as much as possible. One thing to note is that if the protocol is HTTPS, the process of establishing a new connection is even more involved. It requires a complicated process called SSL TLS handshake to establish an encrypted connection between the browser and the server. This handshake is expensive, and the browsers use tricks like SSL session resumption to try to lower the cost. Finally, the browser sends an HTTP request to the server over the established TCP connection. HTTP itself is a very simple protocol. The server processes the request and sends back a response. The browser receives the response and renders the HTML content. Oftentimes, there are additional resources to load, like JavaScript bundles and images. The browser repeats the process above that we mentioned, making DNS lookup, establishing TCP connection, making HTTP requests, to finish fetching all the other resources. If you'd like to learn more about system design, check out our books and weekly newsletter. And please subscribe if you learn something new. Thank you so much, and we'll see you next time.